6 physics, our today's topic is friction. So now start. The force which opposes motion is called frictional force. It means if you are doing motion, like if you are walking, if you are running, then this force arises and it opposes the motion. It means it does not allow to do motion. Contrary to this, friction is beneficial in many ways: walking, running, driving a vehicle, sitting on a chair, and many more. Without these force, life would be impossible. The frictional force acting between two surfaces in contact tends to oppose the motion of one surface over the other. Thus, friction acts between the two surfaces in contact in opposite direction. Okay. So here what it is saying, that if you are doing motion along a straight line, okay, suppose this is a girl and this is walking, she is walking along a straight line, then what a friction force do? It opposes her motion. Okay, if she is walking along a straight line like forward, then the frictional force actions will be backward. Okay, so it basically, the work of frictional force is to oppose the motion. Okay, now our second topic is consequential force. This force means consequential force is the resulting force when a force is applied on an object. For example, when you roll a ball down on the floor, its motion slowly decreases and finally the ball gets stopped. This occurs due to the consequential force acting upon the ball to stop. Okay, so consequential force is known as a resulting force. Resulting force means after all the calculation of forces, the result will come. This force we will call consequential force. For example, suppose if you throw a ball, okay, so you will notice after some time the ball will get automatically stopped. Okay, it means after so many forces the ball will get stopped. Then these forces are called consequential forces. Okay, action at a distance forces. These type of forces does not require any material medium for action. It occurs when two objects are in a physical contact with each other. Okay, it means this type of forces doesn't require any material, any object, any medium. Like if you are throwing a ball in a water, in air. Medium means water, air and land. These forces occurs only when two objects are not in a physical contact with each other. Okay, like here is example of these forces. This is a magnet, this is a magnet. You do not need to be physical for the forces. Okay, you just put a magnet here and second magnet in your hand. If you place a magnet near this magnet, after a certain distance this force will automatically get a force through this magnet. Okay, so you do not need to be any physical contact. This will occur at action at a distance force. Okay, so this is known as a action at a distance force. Okay, now we are talking about electrostatic force. The word electrostate, the current, will important role electrostatic. So here electro means electric current and statics means steady, means at rest. Electrostatic force is due to negative and positive charge. Why this will occur? Due to negative and positive charge. If you comb your dry hair and bring the comb near some bits of paper, it will get attract the bit of paper. Since the comb is electrically charged, so it attracts the bit of paper by applying a force on them. Okay, the force is called electrostatic force. So this is the end of this video. Thank you, class.